We're so used to that outward, that output. But what about that input? You know, what is going on inside of me? How do I feel when this happens? Do I actually learn how to nurture myself? And when you enter the doorstep of mindfulness, you start to look at all of that. And it's not that you start to look at all of that with like a lens of looking, but it shows up. You start to read it. You start to read your own cues. You start to read your own behavior, your own emotions. You start to read your own thoughts. You know, so yeah, it's a ride. And I don't have time is not an excuse. If this is your intention, just like any other intention you set, we go to school so that we can have a career in a certain field. You put in the time, you reap the rewards of it, right? You go to the gym because you want certain results. You eat healthy because you want certain results. Similarly, if you want certain relationships and certain connections in a way that's conducive to well-being and peace and happiness and joy, if that, which is the crux, it's the heart of our life. It's the heart of our existence. Everything else is the to-do. Even eating is a to-do, right?
Exactly.
But mindfulness and building this capacity then will become the only to be, you know, the only to be. Once you get the hang of it, it's like riding a bike.